There's no doubt that the game of basketball has changed over the years, and so has the style and fashion of the game, from on-court looks that have defined generations to pre-game and post-game statements. The fits of the game have definitely evolved. But you know what? Don't just take my word for it. So we're sitting down with Jason Tatum, Ben Simmons, Anthony Davis, and Zion Williamson to hear more.
Off-court fashion has definitely changed over the past 20 years. It's one of the bigger parts of the game today.
Look at the older pictures. You know, guys got 3X sweaters and baggy suits.
Now it's different styles. I mean, you look at Russ. Russ is totally different from James Harden.
In this generation, you see pretty much everybody's own creativity when it comes to their clothes.
It's a part of the game now, and fans really value that. Fans, you know, love to see, you know, what we're wearing, what shoes we're wearing.
Whether some people want to be cozy or some people want to be flashy, you just see so many different things in today's generation.
I think it's big. It's only going to continue to grow, and I'm excited to see in the next 10 years, you know, how fashion has changed from now.
Have you ever worn an outfit that a teammate or a friend gave you so much heat for wearing?
No, I never. There's nothing that I've worn that my teammates were like, "What did you have on?"
No, never. I know if I'm gonna put something on, I feel confident enough to where my teammates won't be able to say anything bad about it.
I don't really go out on a limb like that, you know. And I have teammates who wore some things that guys were like, "All right, hold on."
There was a fit that I had when I was in the bubble that a couple of the guys and the trainers was joking on me about. I had like a flannel jacket and shorts. It was a matching set, white, gray, and light pink. You know, they said I looked like, you know, I was going Easter egg hunting or something.
I mostly wore Jordan brand, like, sweatsuits, to be honest. So if you say something about that, then you disrespect the mic. So it's up to you.
As style off the court has changed, so has style on the court.
I feel like the uniforms have gotten tighter. You know, guys aren't wearing as big jerseys or shorts.
You got the, you know, guys wearing the double arm sleeves. They're wearing the tights, the three-quarter tights, you know, where you see a little bit of your leg with the socks. The shorts are rolled up to, you know, your thighs. The jerseys are really tight.
I think the biggest change is footwear. Shoes, custom shoes, PEs for me.
You got guys wearing crazy color shoes.
I think that's huge. You know, that's another way for guys to express themselves.
These elements of the game continue to evolve, and so has NBA 2K. Users now have more opportunities to create, design, and give their players a style and a fit that's all their own.
When I'm putting my player outfits together, the first thing I'm doing is buying shoes. I'm buying every shoe I can with the VC that I have, on court and off court. And then I'm buying the socks because they have the little ankle socks when you start, and it's like so bad. And I would never play like that. So I get the little crew socks where you can lift them up a little bit. And I usually play as myself in the park and go out there and dominate.
When I'm building my player in 2K, I start with the sneakers. You gotta get some Jordans. It's only right. You just got to. And then I just throw some shorts on them or sweats and then a t-shirt. Nothing too flashy, to be honest.
Gotta get all the J's, retros, the 34s, the 11s. Use most of my VCs on getting shoes. The guy I use in the park looks nothing like me. And I like it that way.
When it comes to building your 2K player style, which NBA players do you take inspiration from?
So, shoe game, PJ Tucker. Bag game, I'll say Bron. Bron got a lot of accessories and watches and bracelets, things like that. So I go with Bron with accessories. And then fit-wise, I'm going with myself. Because I know what I like, so I'm feel comfortable.
In 2K, you want to stand out. You know, you want to stand out. So as far as shoes, I got to go with Duds. He got a 6-shoe game. You know, him and I'll go split between, you know, half the year with Duds, half the year with PJ Tucker. Hats, DeAndre Jordan is huge with the hats, watches, I said myself, the jewelry, like the chains and all that. Montrezl Harrell, Trez always got some bling on, so.
When it comes to who I draw inspiration from on the court and off the court, when it comes to how I dress, personally, nobody. I'm myself. Like I said, I want to be cozy and comfortable. I think a strong fit is just being who you are.
What's your favorite collaboration in NBA 2K? Because I know there are so many, but we have to pick just one.
My favorite collab is, you know, I think it's the Bape book bags. Because obviously everybody can't get those. You know, you gotta be one of the best. So that means you're really good at this game.
No matter what inspires your player's fit, showing it off to the fans is the name of the game. And who knows, maybe seeing how they dress will inspire you as well.
NBA teams fans, it would either be the Lakers or the Knicks.
Which, man, I'll say the Lakers and New York. I might say New York number one.
Philly, Miami, nah. I'm gonna go with Miami. I think Miami has the best fans in terms of fashion, only because you might walk into a game and see people wearing the Miami Vice white like shirts on, white pants. I think that's cool.
When LA fans, you know, particularly Laker fans and Knicks fans go to a game, it is like, okay, I need to wear my best fit and I'm going to be seen.
Whether sitting courtside, walking around the neighborhood, or the actual game of basketball itself. As fashion continues to evolve and change the game, 2K will be right there along with it, every step of the way.